Hi, it's Lori Ballen, real estate agent here in Las Vegas, Nevada, with Lori Ballen Team. And this video is part of my 365 days of KW Command series. I have a YouTube channel, I have a Facebook group, 365 days of command, and then I'm also a coach and trainer for my own independent companies, and I do train on lead generation strategies in KW Command. Today, we're going to take a look at how to create an email signature in Designs. On the left-hand side, we're going to find that little sketch pad, and that is Designs. When you log in for the first time, the middle of your screen is going to be blank. Your instinct is to start clicking up here to start finding items, but you'll notice they're still blank. These are actually folders that hold the designs I've already created. So to create a new design, we're going to click the little plus at the bottom right of the screen. And in this particular case, your instinct might be to go to email to create an email signature, but that's actually how we create an email from scratch, which we're not quite ready for. So instead, we're going to click on social and next. Now, just so that you know, you'll see a lot of the same designs in social and in print, and you're able to go back and forth between those, and you can actually use the designs that are in print for social. So what we're going to do is we're going to go down here, and it is under business basics email signatures. So go ahead and pick one of these email signatures that you like, and we're going to click edit. Now you're going to be able to play with these designs. So I need to add a new picture that I just had taken. So I'm going to go to add, and we're going to click this little arrow to upload. And I'm going to find, let's see, Lori's profile 2020. Let's see where I put that. Okay, there it is. Okay. You can use one that has a background or doesn't have a background. I'm going to click open. I've got other videos where I actually show you how to remove the background from a photo, which is fantastic when you're laying them over on top of another design. Okay, so to replace this photo with our photo, we're going to click it so that the little round wheel shows up. You'll notice, like, if I don't click that, we don't see that little round replace icon. So we click it. Go back over, find the replace icon, and click replace image. That way it'll be put in the right spot there. Okay. Now, if it's not quite, let me get that. If it's not quite coming out the right way there, let me try that one more time. I'm still blurry there. So I'm going to click the undo. There we go. Okay. So I don't know if you notice, sometimes it just takes a minute for the blurriness to go away. And sometimes it takes you clicking on something else. It's an interesting little thing. So now the blur is away. I just kind of want to line that the right way since my picture was sized a little bit differently. There we go. Okay. Now, first name and last name. So you're going to click there and we're going to replace that. Okay. Now we need our license number. So I'm going to tab right after that. I keep mine in Apple Notes so that I can get to everything quickly. There's my license number, and I'm going to paste that right there. Now, if you have this issue where it's not lining up correctly, there's a little side here. You can click and drag it to make it bigger and put that where you want it. Okay. Now you need your KW DBA. I'm going to click on there. And I'm going to go over to logos. And I have a couple of options in here. I have the one that's white, and then I have one where I removed the background. And I have another video that shows you where to go get your KW DBA logo as well. So you're going to want to make sure you have that. And then we're going to click here and replace. Come back. Okay, now I should be there. Yep, replace. Perfect. Then I'm just going to drag that up to where I want that to be. And you can make it bigger by dragging. Okay, good. So now there's a little, see where it says each office is independently owned and operated? There's a typo there. I'm not sure where that's coming from. So I'm going to fix it. Office is, okay. Now, mobile phone number. Oh, okay. So that'll reach my team. And then an office number if you're required to have one, or you want to put something on there, or you want to put another number of any kind. And then here I'm going to put my, I'm required to put our office. I'm going to put Keller Williams Realty, Las Vegas, Summerlin. Tab down or hit enter. And we are at 9400 West Sahara, number 100, Las Vegas, Nevada, 89117. Okay, and now your email. So you're going to do the same thing, just highlight the whole thing. And team at ballenvegas.com. Okay, underneath that, your website. And then download my KW app. You're going to want your URL there. So I save mine up here. You know, I think in another video, I will show you how to go register a domain for this in GoDaddy and point it so that you have something smaller there without that text code if you want. In fact, this is kind of, this signature is not going to be a clickable signature. It's going to be an image. So to have that, nobody's going to go type all that in. So you definitely want to go get a domain name and register it there so that you have like, so mine would be something like Ballen Vegas app or something like that. So that it's easy for them to remember. Okay. Maybe I'll go do that after this so then we can see what it looks like. Okay. So once this is however I want it to be, and if I want to move things around, like let's just say I want the, I prefer the address over there underneath the logo, I could do something like that. And then I could put that there. Or let's just say I want these larger so I can increase the size of that, these important items here. See, and we just are making those now a 12 instead of an 8. So those are a little bit more obvious. If I wanted to put a tagline here or something like that, I could do that as well. All right, once you have this how you want it, we're going to do a couple of things. First, we're going to rename it. And I'm going to call this Lori's email signature. And then file, save. Then click the little arrow to download it. And we'll just go ahead and download that in a JPEG. Click start download. And then we're going to save it, Lori's email signature. Now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go over to Gmail. Make sure you're logged into the account you want to be logged into. So I'm going to log into Lori Vegas Ballen, which is our team Gmail address. Okay, now we're going to go over to signatures. So we're going to click this little wheel on the upper right, settings. Click settings. And then we are going to go down to signature, which is right here. And you can see right now I have no signature. This is a new Gmail inbox we just set up for our team. Okay, now we're going to choose if we want to append this signature, the end of all messages, which we do. Now we're going to go to this little insert image. Upload, select a file, then find your signature. We're going to drop that in there. There it is. Now, we can link that picture by clicking link. Hold on, let me see if I can. Oh, maybe not. Let me see. HTTPS ballenvegas.com. Okay, so no, that just puts the URL below. Okay, so if we want to have anything clickable, it looks like what we want to do is put those signatures underneath that or above that, if there's anything else that we want to be clickable. So here, do we want to insert this signature before quoted text and replies and remove the line that precedes it? That's up to you. But that's how you drop in that signature. Pretty simple. And you can play with a couple of the white or the red to see which one looks better. Go ahead and subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this one, 365 Days of KW Command. I'm Lori Ballen in Las Vegas, Nevada.